Now Sarah has shown you another example of an interface, and I hope you've become more familiar with how they work. They're really pretty natural, but when you think about it, there is something mysterious going on. In our suburban scene, we had an array list of drawables, houses, cars, dogs, and so on. We got one of them, stored it in a variable of type drawable, of course, then called the draw method on it. That has to work. D belongs to the drawable type, and drawable has a draw method. What's D? It's a variable, so it holds a reference to an object. An object of what class? You might think it's an object of class drawable, but wait a minute. There is no class drawable. Drawable is an interface, so that can't be it. And in fact, there's no way of knowing to which class this object belongs. There's only one thing that we know about it. This object belongs to some class that has a draw method. And in fact, as you loop over the various elements in the array list, this line of code may call different methods. The draw method of the house class, the dog class, or of some other class so far unimagined that also chooses to implement the drawable interface. This variation is called polymorphism, which is just a fancy word for saying different shapes. In our scene, that's a very appropriate name, because the draw method can draw entirely different shapes depending on what the implementing class does. But the term polymorphism is used generally in Java to indicate any situation where you have a method call and the actual method called depends on the type of the object. Now, why is polymorphism important? It lets us build expandable systems where we can add new types without having to change the essential logic of the program. I'd like you to try this out and add a new type to our suburban scene, namely a ball class. It's simply the kind of ball that you might find lying on a street. And when you do that, note how little of the program you have to change.